YouTube's hypocrisy is entirely out of hand. Now, this is kind of a follow-up to my last video really talking about YouTube because, as that video has come out and afterwards, I have noticed so many different shining examples of YouTube's corporate hypocrisy that just seems to completely destroy everything that they've apparently been working for. So, in the case of Monkey Jones, which if you are somehow still unaware of what happened there, Monkey made, I guess, dark humor content, and one of his videos was talking about Elliot Rodgers, who was obviously a mass shooter, and he basically, like, read his manifesto, made fun of the dude, obviously in satire, and, you know, just kind of really, I guess, talked about the whole situation. And in this sweeping effort, all of a sudden, YouTube's going through and deleting content off the platform that they don't find is right, so it's just, it's crazy to me, man, because it's so apparent that Monkey Jones is not what they're trying to pretend that he is, but, man, If they can get it that way, man, they'll do whatever they can. Apparently, a private video that Monkey had uploaded was taken down due to shocking, sensational, disrespectful manners, including promoting, glorifying, or encouraging violence, which in this situation was mass shootings because it was related to Elliot Rodgers or whatever. Just it's ignorant. It's all it really comes down to. And then they go on to say context is also important. The only depictions of such activities that we may allow need to be educational or documentary in nature and shouldn't be designed to help or encourage others to imitate them. Here's a good resource on context, which is funny because if YouTube really kind of got the context behind the videos that they've deleted, they'd realize that it is satire and that it is not posted in a shocking, sensational, or disrespectful manner. Now, here's what I find really funny about this point, right? They're all against all this sensational and shocking content. They don't want any content that promotes violence or depicts violence or anything like mean like that in nature that's posted to shock or anything. But you know what's really funny? One of the most popular videos on the internet this year, and especially on YouTube, literally is one of YouTube's top creators literally just desecrating a body hanging in the Japanese forest, which, by the way, made it on the trending page of YouTube, okay? You know what's ironic about that? I think we can all, if you really have a brain and you think this one through, right? Which is honestly worse, okay? Think about this. Before you say anything fucking ignorant, just go ahead and just let it process. Which is worse? A satirical video that makes fun of a mass shooter, but also covers why he might have done what he did and covers the mental health problems that kind of surrounded this man, once again, in a satirical, dark satirical way. Or B, a creator literally going into a forest that is ruthlessly known for the amount of suicides that it generally entails, finding a body hanging from one of the trees, once again in a forest known for how many suicides take place there annually, deciding to film it, mock it, and laugh at it for minutes on edge, review all of that content, edit it together in a vlog, and then post it on the page, which made it on the trending tab and had tens of millions of views, if we're counting all the re-uploads, things like that, had just a completely ridiculous amount of articles written about it that gave YouTube plenty of negative press, clearly actually violated a lot of terms of service here on the platform, and once again, literally desecrates a dead fucking body in the forest for YouTube views. Which one's worse, the jokey video that makes fun of weirdos, or the video in which some moron goes into a suicide forest and mocks a dead body, which has been there for God knows how long, and then uploads it for the whole world to see so he can make a couple fucking dollars, right? I think anybody with an IQ of over about 8 can say, well, you know what, I think the desecration of a dead man in a forest is a little bit worse than some jokes. But if you're YouTube, that's not what you think. You don't think that one through, and of course, that video, they don't want to talk about that. But did you see Logan Paul's channel get deleted? Did you see his accounts get terminated? The worst, I think, that he actually got was YouTube kind of stopped doing some of their YouTube original business with him for just a little bit. He got taken out of the Google preferred ads and whatnot for like a month, and then literally once all the negative press kind of just shut up, they, you know, just accepted him back in the projects and everything. They gave him all his ads and stuff back, making that nice, sweet CPM, making all those millions off of, you know, showing dead bodies in the forest. And even then, he's in YouTube originals and all kinds of shit. It's clear that they're doing business with him. They obviously endorse him, and that's because he makes the platform a butt ton of money. Now, the difference between him and Mumkey is that Mumkey did not make YouTube a shit ton of money, and that Mumkey was obviously a much smaller creator than Logan Paul. They could, at least they thought, they could kind of sweep this one under the rug, right? Like, yeah, no one's gonna notice that we fucked this guy's career over because our stupid system auto-flags his content and then we manually review it, and because we don't like it, it's over, right? I just find that a little bit hypocritical of him, right? That's a tad bit funny to me. And what's funny is that with the whole Article 13 thing going down in Europe, which obviously is a very bad thing going on, YouTube is suddenly against all of this corporate money and all these laws and shit that are gonna just block all this stuff going on YouTube, gonna really hurt YouTube with all these new copyright laws and stuff like that. And they're all about this, imagine if you couldn't see the videos that you love, hashtag save your internet. Well, what's funny is that if you're a Mumkey Jones fan, you literally can't see the videos that you love because of YouTube's corporate hypocrisy. Now, this is the funny one here. When it comes to all these other corporations and shit that have banded together to, I guess, enforce copyright a lot more stricter, not even a little bit, just like borderline intrusion of artistic value by this Article 13. YouTube's suddenly all against it. They don't want all these corporations and just getting through all this shit, right? But when YouTube's the corporation with some power and they get the ability to enforce some dumbass rules on their platform and they can suppress content on their own platform that they don't like and that they don't agree with, they will snap on that chance. I just find that really ironic, YouTube. I mean, I thought it was all about, you know, all these videos that you love should have the ability to come onto YouTube. So what's the whole deal here? Now, there is a really bad example coming up. Like, it, not bad as in, like, it doesn't make sense, but just it's fucking terrible, man. So remember when YouTube said, oh, we can't have all this shocking content that's uploaded, obviously, to shock and to promote violence, right? We can't have that. Well, there was a Chilean YouTuber who was uploading content on his channel, okay? And he uploads this video basically where he abuses this cat and then later kills it, talks about the process, this just garbage, right? Just terrible shit. And thankfully, by time that I made this video, this channel has been terminated, but I'm sure he's gonna be back any fucking moment now. But this video had 900,000 views. I'm not exaggerating that. This video literally detailed his abuse and killing of a cat. Was like 15 minutes, had like literally almost 1 million views. Had like 800,000 dislikes compared to like 2,000 likes from a bunch of fucking weirdo Eugenes who should be beaten until they're senseless, right? But yeah, this was just up on the platform for a while. It wasn't automatically flagged, apparently wasn't even manually flagged enough. The only reason that this channel was ever fucking deleted was because of people making videos about it and tweeting at YouTube on Twitter. I was one of these people, but there was plenty of other more popular tweets that had gotten the message to them first, thankfully, and that's where I kind of found out about this whole thing anyways. But even though that tweet had been 3 hours old and YouTube said that the channel was going to be taken down 3 hours before that, I was still able to access that video 3 hours before YouTube issued a statement on it. So for 3 hours, this hundreds of thousands of viewed video just was literally detailing this horrible tragedy to an animal, a helpless animal at that. And all of a sudden, YouTube wasn't there to enact their policy. This huge platform that is all about enforcing this stupid-ass rule that they obviously only enforce when it really only is in their favor. It just was nowhere to be found. There was no enforcement whatsoever until a big deal was made about it. Thankfully, I can't show you any of the video. It's gone. I wouldn't anyway because it's fucking terrible and I'd never subject someone to seeing that and hearing what he was saying and stuff. But if you want some more details and you want some more, I guess, information regarding what had happened, The Quartering made a great eight-minute-long video about the whole thing. I will link that in the description. It's just outrageous to me and it's so hypocritical. I mean, someone makes jokes on the internet, on YouTube, makes jokes that actually have, obviously, a little bit of value to them in mental health and whatnot anyways. Can't have that, man. Can't have content YouTube doesn't agree with, but hey, your cat abuse video, get it to 1 million views, baby. It's just extremely hypocritical, man, and yeah, it's funny to me how low YouTube has stooped as a platform and just how much evidence they give to their favoritism, their corporation mentality, and basically their war against creators they don't agree with. And for the last real big bit of hypocrisy here, and of course it's gonna tie right back into Mumkey's video, don't you love how YouTube Rewind, they're all about all this, you know? How about we take a minute to respect the people who stood up and spoke about mental health this year? And then when Mumkey does pretty much exactly that, except with some dark satire twisted into it, really, kind of getting in the mind of that shooter, not a school shooter, but a shooter, Elliot Rodgers, reading his manifesto and whatnot, you know, right there. That kind of mental health, talking about it in that perspective, humiliating this man for the shitty act that he committed, but also kind of diving into why he did it, that can't be there. That's too sensational. But hey, we're all about it here on the platform, guys, all about your mental health, you know? We gotta talk about mental health, unless it's a topic we don't want you to talk about. I think we need to start covering the mental health of these goddamn YouTube employees, man. This is just, it's outrageous. So yeah, YouTube is just it's a big hypocrite company, really. There's nothing more to it. They're not gonna reinstate his channels. They're not gonna let him back on the platform. They've made that very apparent. And it's only gonna get worse from here. That's just real talk. Thank you guys for watching the video. If you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like. Subscribe if you're brand new around here. Follow me on Twitter at SubToOptimus. Join the Discord down below. Thank you to my channel members for your $5 a month. Your contribution to the channel helps it tremendously. And until my next video, guys, this is Optimus. Just all about the rights. All about all these people. We gotta save our internet. We gotta save all this content. Imagine not being able to watch the content you really like and play and wanting to see. I don't even know what that was. That was just gibberish. Anyways, signing out.